Hey guys.
So this Christmas was awesome. I got into magic again, which is great.
I used to love magic and I used to do it all the time. And now I'm back, but I'm older, so I haven't been doing any magic in the past videos or anything. But I'm getting back into it because I used to do it a lot. Which is like 2 years ago, and I got like magic kits and stuff, and all I wanted for Christmas was magic. But this Christmas, I focused on my YouTube and my new interests, gaming. I used to never play video games, and I used to hate them. Then I started playing them a little bit, and I kind of got good at them, and I liked them, because the only reason I really didn't like them is because I wasn't good at them. So, I learned to accept the fact that I wasn't very good at video games, and practice, because I would come over to my friend's house and they'd be like, "Hey, wanna play some video games?" And I'd be like, "I really hate video games, you know that?" And they'll be like, "Oh." And then we'd be bored and we'd never be able to play. Now I'll come back and they'll be like, "Let's play Zombies, I'm Black Ops 2, I got Newtown." I'm like, "It was 60 freaking bucks, I don't see why you paid that much." They're like, "Well, it comes out with every micro," and I was like, "Are you in them?" Because I don't think that's that big of a deal. So, because all it is like some map packs with zombies and stuff, like Newtown. I play Newtown all the time. Just because zombies are in it doesn't make it that better. Kind of like a kind of small map, and it has a lot of different like places, whatever. So let's get to the trick. I'm really sorry. So I got PS3, and I got a laptop, and I got a ukulele, because I'm starting to get into music a lot. So let's get into the trick that I'm going to teach you. Amazing trick. So as you read in the title, the card mouth trick. It's not the one where I cough up your card. That's very, very complicated, and like it's really hard, and it's just too good of a trick. So I can't teach you guys it. Sorry. It's very popular to me because it gets me all of like the fame, like whatever, and all the laughs and smiles. Sorry. So here's the trick. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to have a false shuffle. You can force it to the bottom of the deck. Usually it's forced to the top, but it's really the forcing right now that I'm going to teach you has to do with making it at the bottom. I mean, I would get it at the top, but it's just, I don't know what it is. So, here we go. I hope you didn't already click off this video, but if you did, those of you who are still watching, good for you because you're about to getting on a lot. Alright, so here's the performance. Tell you to choose a card. Say choose one. Say this one. It's the 10 of spades. It really doesn't matter. I'll tell them to put it on the top of the deck. Just like so. Take a little bit of the deck. Put it in the middle. Take a little bit of the shuffle. Yeah. What I was thinking, you know, wouldn't it be cool if I could do something like, wait, you know, never mind. Find your card. So while they're doing that, they're looking through the deck. Looking. Okay, it's not in here. Really? There's your card. So it's very effective because that's exactly how it's going to look to them. So you may thought like, oh, I'm doing something underneath the camera. I am, but it would be the same as showing it in real life. So, I'm gonna make this quick, my computer battery's running out. So, here's the tutorial. So you have them select a random card, anyone. Okay. I'm really sorry about that. So it's the King of Diamonds. So you'll have them place it on top of the deck, just like regular. You'll take about a fourth of the deck, just like that. And then you'll put like a little pinky in there, push it up, make a gap, push in the deck. What you're doing is you're making like half of that fourth in there, and you're pushing it in the other half of the fourth on top. Now you're taking another little fourth, you're putting on the bottom, and doing it again for their cards at the top. Now since this is at the top, what you're gonna do is you can leave it at that and just skip through this part, but this part just gives it a little bigger shuffle. So it's kinda like makes it a little more realistic. So you go like this, you show the deck, and you do this shuffle. It's a shuffle kind of thing. So right now their card's on top, and you really want to focus on keeping it that way. So watch my card shift from here. This is how it looks to me. There's a card at the bottom. I'm taking the little parts of the deck and I'm putting them down. And as I'm doing this right now, the King Diamonds is left, and I just put one card down, just like that. Their card's at the bottom. Now what I'm doing is I'm looking in their eyes, and as I'm looking in their eyes, I'm saying, wouldn't it be cool? I'm flipping over the deck to face me. Then I'm going like a little teeter-totter. So what it really is I'm sliding off the top card, at the top card, sliding off the, well, technically it's the top card, but technically it's the bottom. So, because you flipped it over. I'm sliding it off, covering it up, and then I'm just like, wouldn't it be cool if I could, you know what, never mind. And right now you're just hanging this at the bottom, not focusing on it at all. Don't look at it, because then they'll look where you're looking. So you'll give them the deck, and they're like, just find your card. They'll look through it, and they'll find it. Well, while they're looking for it, and they're like searching through, you already have their card. So right now you're just going like this. And then they're searching for their card, looking through the deck, and when they can't find it, they'll look at you and they're like, I can't find it. And you'll be like, really? And it's in your mouth. Great trick. Check it out.